つもありがとう、本当ありがとう、たとえどこにだって君の存在に感謝してるよ。いつも支えてくれる人たちに日頃の思いを込めたラプソディ、アプレシエーションの気持ちを届け、いつもありがとう、本当ありがとう、たとえどこにだって君の存在に感謝してるよ。
Comic-Con. I don't know about anybody else. So I want to impart with you guys, as it is closing ceremonies, a tradition started in the second year by a man who said that this is the song that should be the national anthem for the United States of America. Please get a, give it up for Don't Stop Believing by Journey.
Thank you. Wait, I stop. I get it first.
Thank you.
Who's an embarrassment? Stop trouble.
Sorry, I'm a little tired. I don't have time. Dancing. Whew. So, thank you guys very much for coming out to Comic-Con. The guests loved you guys. Like, I don't know how to explain this. Every guest who came out was like, y'all are some of the best people that they ever had to work with, and they've done hundreds of cons. They worked for hundreds of cons all across the United States, and then some, and they loved you.
We got the best congoers, baby.
We do have the best congoers. I absolutely love you guys.
We love you too.
10 more years. 10 more years.
10 more years. 10 more years. 10 more years. 10 more years.
If I can do it, yes, yes, I would do. I would go for 10 more years. Wow, 10 years. That's a long time. So, it's a little story time with Comic-Con at the moment.
History lesson.
History lesson. Right. Over 10 years ago, I hit a dark point in my life. Really bad relationship situations. You know, family and things not going well. College not going well because of the said other problems, you know, issues with faith and whatnot, had some serious problems at that time, and I feel that I was personally saved. I hit a moment of enlightenment after following my usual patterns. Basically, I was just a dead rock at home. I would go out to eat, I'd go out to, and I had this habit of going to Books A Million and buying a manga, about 3 mangas, once a week. And that was pretty much the only outlet I had. Aside from that, I was just crashing. And I did it, and I think I got to the end of a series, and I learned to accept that I was happy with how the series ended, even though I wanted to read more of the series. And for some reason, that connected me to the idea of it's okay for some things to end. And I kind of felt a weight come off of me of all my troubles and things like that, relationships, family problems, other things, and I said, just let it end. And it was the anime community that helped me pull out of that problem, and I spent a long time trying to give back to that community. I love the anime community. And so I started posting anime videos on anime on YouTube. I became the 12th viewed most YouTube channel for months and months. It was Dial Outsider. I basically was a YouTube streamer illegally, and I'm sorry. I was bad, but I was a kid. but yeah, I posted it fast, I posted it hard, and then TV Tokyo came out and started like banning everybody, and I needed a new outlet. Decided to run a con.
That's a turnaround.
Always try to go big, and started a club in the university. These wonderful, wonderful people came. Thought I was crazy. I thought they were crazy, but we put it together. We had year one at the University of Alabama, and year after year, we got bigger. We got better, we got smarter, we had our hiccups, but we did it our way. We always tried to learn from ourselves and growing forth and trying to make this con. Our number one rule, by the way, is always make this con the best con ever. The best con we can possibly make it now. People have said back when we were younger, like, oh, you can't bring that guest or this situation. How are we gonna top it next year? And I said, don't worry about it. We're gonna try to top it next year because next year we're gonna be the best con we can possibly make. And if we end up making basically the same con, then that's the best we can do, you know? But we've kept growing. And it's kept going and growing and growing. And it's 10 years now. and I'm really happy to see you all here. I'm really happy to have made it 10 years. And sorry. Thank you. This con, I don't tell this story every year. This is, I think, I give snippets of it, but this con is a labor of love. Not just mine. It's everybody. You know, the staff works really hard, and there's an insane amount of professionalism from them. But from me personally, because I'm just the one talking right now. That's all. This is my love to the community. Like, this is my love letter to the community. And that's what it's been about. That's what it's always been about. And it's unless something like crazy happens to me, that's what it will always be about. I'm very, very happy to consider you guys part of my family. It's been 10 years. It's been a hard and wonderful, beautiful 10 years. And I am... Sorry, I've had people come up crying to me about just thanking for this to be a thing. I've had people write letters about how this con has stopped suicides. I have seen unfortunate moments where people have even committed suicide from this, from being barred from the con because their parents wouldn't let them come. I've seen a lot of emotional things involved with this family. And I'm just so happy to have you all here. I'm so happy to see you all. I'm so happy to see you all every year. And I know back when we were our first year and there was only 400 of you, I was able to just recognize every single one of your faces and know most of you by name. And I can't anymore. There's too many of you. That's why you got name tags. But I really, really am someone who considers you family. I want to take care of you, and the way I can do that is try to make the best con I possibly can at the most affordable prices I possibly can, and try to create an experience in the state of Alabama that you guys did not have before. Bring guests that have not been here before. Create events that have not been here before. You know, bring people that can make concerts that you have not seen before. that's what it's about. And I'm so happy to see you all stick it with us for 10 years. It's amazing, and I'm very thankful. So thank you for coming to Comic-Con's closing ceremony for year 10. We have the conclusion for the Shio and Kosho game. So I'm going to let the actors hit the stage. All right, thank you.
Hello, and welcome to Comic-Con Closing Ceremonies. I hope you guys had a wonderful time this year.
I know I did. The cosplays were gorgeous, the guests were wonderful, and the raid was lit!
I took many pictures of you amazing heroes.
Yeah, and that bald head of yours? Made for an excellent reflector.
Hey, don't get cocky just because you have a majestic full set of hair.
I know. Oh my god, you just one-punched the invisible girl!
I wasn't actually punching hard!
I'm okay. I just made a trip to the wonderful EMTs who were kind enough to help out the congoers all weekend. Thank you, EMTs!
I'm sure she's fine. I mean, I know that me and you have probably been in worse spots, right, Yamcha?
Oh my!
Only a few times?
Oh well, but in any other case, we also need to thank the BJCC staff and security for helping us out. Show.
And let's not forget you guys. The heart of the cards, I mean crowd, is the most important part of any convention.
I had it, guys! I had the results! After all the battles and epic games that we've been playing this year, I have your voice.
Yo, wait, I thought Umaru had the results.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure staff said they were going to get the results to Umaru. Yeah. I guess I'll go get her, is what I meant.
Anyway, while we wait for the results, I just wanted to thank you all for enjoying 10 years with us here at Comic-Con.
We've been here together this long. Well, I mean, I have. You've only been here for like 9 years, Scotia.
Shots fired.
Okay, you know what? That uppity big sister behavior of yours is why Nintendo is leaving stars for moons.
Yeah. That's it. Come get some.
Nothing.
Take it. Anyway, now that we have the voice of the con, the admiral that will be leading the battle in the planet of their choice next year is...
I mean, they have before.
Silence, loser!
We recorded the continuity. That doesn't count.
You should have loved me more!
Well,
you're too young for us!
Anyway.
Eat at Joe's.
Anyway. That's all the time we have, my lovely congoers who voted for me. So, I really hope to see you all next year when we'll be back in full force. Bye-bye! Bye-bye!
Bye-bye.
She is salty.
She's pure salty.
Do it!
Redo.
It's just the sound.
else is doing.
Hello, hello.
Hello.
Hello, okay. I was like, if anybody doesn't know why that's a thing, Melancholy of Haru Suzumiya was a very big year, the year when we started, very big during when we started the convention. And the Batman SOS Brigade is based off the SOS Brigade, which is from that anime. They haven't made a new episode or light novel in a long time because they keep giving that author money so he doesn't need to work.
Like our government!
Okay, no politics. It's not for politics. We're a con for anime, gaming, and comics.
Yeah, so Bill Clinton.
But yeah, no, they like recently made a whole bunch of pachinko machines for him, so he's gonna get royalties for every single one of those. I was like, make him broke. I want more. All right. Thank you very much for coming out. As you heard, Shio and the World of Video Games will be the theme for next year. So next year, welcome to the planet of video games at Comic-Con Season 11. We're happy to have you guys, and that's it for closing ceremonies. We will be doing a Q&A, answering questions Q&A. I want just want to ask and know if you want to leave, you want to stay, that's fine, but we're just going to ask and find out what you loved about the con, what you disliked about the con, what you would want changed. Ticket prices. Oh, I'm sorry. Attendance number will be 7,527. So, yep, we're happy to have it. We brew about 1,000, so we're happy to have it. Thank you very much, guys. Thank you for coming out.